Trying to be a sustained beast in the mid lane.
They have a lot of options, a bit of a foothold. Zed as well.
They do have Rek'Sai, but and the problem is Vladimir is good against Zed anyway.
Yeah.
I can't see.
I
wouldn't, if I was TSM, pick the Zed here. Bjergsen might have his other ideas for this one, but in my mind, it's not a great pickup here for Bjergsen. Hovering for now, but whatever. Cyan for Dyrus, I think, is a very good choice. Another big frontline tank. I want to see if Bjergsen
leveled
does
the Lucian, who 50 CS or not, hasn't bought any items yet. Dyrus is more powerful in this new one-on-one.
Nardius recalls hiding away. Like, Dyrus is getting really massive. And you still have a really awkward two-on-two of a low-level Vladimir who can't really do much.
Yeah, and Maokai as well doesn't mind about being a little bit under-itemed, but he wants those levels. And the fact that Dyrus has been able to just sit in brushes in the top lane and take it all
around that dragon. The thing is, I don't think TSM are going to force it anytime soon. And Vashik just are not really in the position to start it themselves. So unless they fully cleared it and Rek'Sai knew there was no vision.
And I don't really agree with this by Bashikosh as well. They're sending their duo lane towards the top side of the map when Dragon now definitely something that they need to be thinking about.
Well, if you swap it now.
You run up to the Dragon. Bjergsen already had pressure in the mid lane. This guy's up 40 CS in the mid lane. That's basically free for TSM. They greed for a dive. That fails. They give up all the advantage they had from that kill. Sure, they're accruing a gold lead. TSM are winning, but it's sloppy.
Yeah, we are being very critical, but they definitely have a substantial lead,
yeah.
And they don't have to, you know, do anything that is even remotely risky right now.
I suppose not.
If the game continues as is, it looks very solid for them.
And it's not only the fact that Bjergsen has a CS lead, he's taken the turret already as well, with no actual rotation by anyone. He's just naturally destroyed a turret on his own.
And of course, TSM have done a very good job. The one thing I will commend them a lot for is not only their laning phase, but their ward control. They've really not allowed Theocles
to continue on with the chain dragons for themselves. Everyone's in position, and once again, even if they do, if they go 4-1 and they have Vladimir matching up with Maokai, not only can Dyrus stop the Maokai teleport,
oh,
or stop the Vladimir teleport if he channels first.
You, yeah? I need to stop you because that's a Luden's Echo.
Yeah.
That's beautiful.
It is.
We haven't seen one yet. I'm just like, I'm super excited. MSI's first Luden's Echo, and I love this item, and it's on the team.
He's gonna have a lot of poke with that one.
Yeah. Take everything away. It's sort of like the slow loss.
Yeah.
They've got to make a solid move here around the map, make some change something, because they're just slowly losing this game.
Oh, that's the case. But the one lane that Bashikas are actually getting a push lead in would be that Vladimir lane. Fodern is generally killing the minion wave first. Dyrus is typically respecting that. But Vlad's not a great turret killer anyway, and trying to run away from the slow burn of Maokai Sejuani is not easy either. So with the current sort of item set, you're right, there's no good push pressure from Bashikas. TSM do have siege power.
Yep, here's that 4-1 we were looking for. You know, we have the Ziggs and the Sivir instantly clearing out waves. So much zoning power with those two as well. You can see the minefield goes down. Large chunk out of the turret. Dyrus got the top wave pushed up as well. So TSM can easily make a rotation. They have Sivir ultimate available.
And Double Joe just gets chunked out. They easily take down the turret. Thaldren now forced to use the pull. Lust Boy gets the flash for his death sentence. But that could mean the inner turret here on the top lane as well. And TSM surgically removing structures.
Yeah, two people not going to be part of this fight. Thaldren knocked well out. Morgana still healing right here, so great rotation by TSM. Dyrus gets the push. He chunks out the Vladimir, and there we go. Two more turrets knocked down. Team still in mid, looking like a game faster than 38 minutes.
Yeah, it could even be just move down to the bottom side. The thing of warding up this Baron here is...